Hello everyone, Bob Rizzuti, Orange County, California. We are here today again with another video. This time is about API 570, how to determine minimum required thickness. So based on the requirement of the API 570, we have to consider two key items when we want to determine what is the minimum required thickness for process piping that being placed in the service. And what is that thickness? If we pass that minimum required thickness, we need to perform fitness for services, or we have to replace the that piece of the piping. So the based of the requirement, we have to first calculate pressure design thickness based of this formula, which we taken from the API 574 section 12.1.2. It's the same formula which is in the ASME B31.3, but it's simplified a little bit, but it's almost the same formula. So we have a P is a design pressure, D outside diameter, and then 2 is a factor, and S is an allowable stress at the design temperature, and the E is a joint efficiency, and it's a longitudinal joint efficiency for the piping material that we're gonna use. After we calculated this wall thickness that we calculated is the thickness that we need. This wall thickness is the thickness that we need just to overcome the pressure, internal pressure there in the piping that is caused by fluid, which is the same as the hoop stress. But that's wall thickness that we calculated might not be enough from the structural point of view. You know, the process piping is gonna be in the pipe support, and then the weight of the piping and the loading that is gonna be caused by the connecting rotating equipment or the steel structure, and then might cause buckling and sagging. All of these things might be happen. For that point of view, we have to also consider structural minimum thickness and then compare these two wall thickness and the pick the one is higher as our minimum required thickness. The structural minimum thickness address on the API 574 table 7. So for each pipe size, we have a certain value that we can consider. So for purpose of the minimum required thickness for process piping that being placed in service, we have to calculate pressure design thickness and read the number from the table 7 for that certain pipe sizes, and then compare them, which one is higher. We're gonna take that one as a minimum required thickness. We're gonna have an example. We are going to review this example given for us as a material of construction is ASTM A106 grade B, like this material here. And then our design temperature is 100 degree Fahrenheit. Our design pressure is 600 PSI. The size is, we assume the size is 12 inch. And then what is the minimum required thickness? First, we have to write down the equation from the API RP 574 and calculate the minimum design thickness. For this formula, P is design pressure, plug in the numbers, and the D is the outside diameter. This is the nominal side, this is the outside side, and outside diameter of the 12 inch pipe, there's a table on the API RP 574. Whenever you need a pipe to see what's the outside diameter, you can check that. Up to the 12 inch, it's gonna be something's over the nominal, but after the 12 inch, like a 14 inch pipe, the outside diameter is gonna be the same 14 inch, or 16, the same 16. 18 inch is gonna be the same 18 inch. But here for 12 inch, our outside diameter is 12.75. And then 2 is a factor, S is an allowable stress at the 100 degree Fahrenheit, which you're gonna read this number from the A1 table in the ASME B31.3. You're gonna go to the A1 table, locate 100 degree Fahrenheit, and also locate the ASTM A106 grade B and read this value 20,000 PSI from there. You're gonna calculate the minimum design thickness. Pressure design thickness is going to be 0.19 inch, which we need this wall thickness to overcome the internal pressure of the liquid which is going to be transferred in our piping system. Now we have to verify to see for this 12-inch pipe with the 100 degree Fahrenheit design temperature, what is the minimum structural thickness? We're going to go to the table 7 on the API RP574, and in the table temperature is less than 400 degree Fahrenheit, and then the structural minimum thickness for the size of the 12 inch is going to be 0.11 inch. Now we have to compare this value with this value and take the one is higher. So this value and this value, 0.19 inch is over the structural minimum thickness, and then we're gonna consider this one. Consider for a moment, this was like 0.1, which is gonna be less than this, then we would have taken 0.11 inch. So this is the simple way to determine how you should calculate the minimum pressure design thickness, and also how you're gonna calculate the minimum design pressure thickness and the compare with the table 7 and the pick the one is higher. See you guys in next video.